नमस्ते मनोज जी, नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, एंड वेलकम टू आवर 15th एडिशन ऑफ स्वर श्रवण. एंड एज वी गियर अप फॉर द थैंक्स गिविंग हॉलीडेज, लेट्स टेक अ मोमेंट टू एक्सप्रेस आवर सिंसियर थैंक्स टू मनोज सर फॉर ब्रिंगिंग द अनसंग हीरोज ऑफ आवर क्लासिकल म्यूजिक टू अस थ्रू दीज मंथली प्रेजेंटेशंस. सो without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to you, sir. Manoj sir, thank you.
Thank you, Seshadri ji, and namaskar everyone. Session number 15, and today it is the turn of instrumental music, and we are going to talk about an instrument which is normally used as an accompanying instrument. Of course, we do listen to that as a solo instrument also from time to time, but it is popularly known as an accompanying instrument. And which instrument are we talking about? We are talking about harmonium. Yes, we are talking about harmonium. And one of the legends of harmonium playing is what we're going to talk about today. Somebody who came from a very, very humble background and rose to the greatest heights and inspired so many students to take up harmonium as a full-time profession. And that in itself is an amazing feat. And whom are we talking about today? The legendary harmonium player, Pandit Tulsidas Borkar ji. Yes, Pandit Tulsidas Borkar ji.
Kya baat?
You know, we are just so excited to talk about him today. You know, somebody who is an absolute master at accompanying various styles of artists, at the same time a real wizard when it came to playing solo. So Panditji, and coincidentally, this I came to know when I was reading about him for the purpose of this program. We will be celebrating his birth anniversary on coming Thursday, November 18th. So how appropriate is it for us to be doing this? And it's just an amazing coincidence that we are doing this. So Panditji, born on November 18th, 1934. And unfortunately, he passed away on September 29th, 2018, at the age of 84. But even when we listen to him talk, we will know as to how humble he was, humble to the core, but at the same time, so very well respected. And we are going to listen to his harmonium playing today, not just classical music, but also the amazing ability of Panditji to be able to play Sugam Sangeet, that is light music, on the harmonium. And I can tell you that that's actually even more difficult, because in light music, words play such an important part. So for a vocalist, it's sometimes easier to present songs because he's actually saying the words. But for somebody to play so effectively and so magically on the harmonium, which already has a few limitations as an instrument, but despite that, to be able to play so brilliantly light music on the harmonium too. So that is something truly amazing. So that's what we're going to listen to. But as always, we'll start with classical music. And we begin with one of the most popular rags and taught as the first rag in many of the music schools, Rag Yaman, in which Panditji is going to be playing a composition in Madhyalay Jhaptal, which is 10 beats cycle, followed by a composition in Drut Teen Tal, in which you will hear, you know, all his mastery and his wizardry, especially when it comes to playing the jhala on the harmonium, which is such a difficult thing to play. Now, jhala is something that is played on string instruments, but the greatness with which Panditji plays the jhala on the harmonium is just simply worth listening. So here we go, Rag Yaman.
File info, 01 Rag Yaman, selected, button, back, top of screen, back, top of screen, lock screen, button, video track, button, pause, button. Speech off.
Mm. लयकारी क्या बात है ध्रुतीन ताल। दिस इज द झाला। Uh-huh. I mean, isn't that so amazing? Just absolutely spellbound. It just feels as if he probably has not, of course, like five fingers we use normally to play the harmonium, four or five, but it feels as if he has maybe 20 fingers with which he's playing the harmonium. It's just so amazing, you know. And some of these things I can tell you that they are not easy to play on the harmonium. Harmonium is a very deceptive instrument. People think that, oh, it'll just pump that bellow and just press the keys. But it's just not that. There is so much more into harmonium playing. And like I said, it's a very deceptive instrument. It can make people feel that it is so easy to play. But then once you start playing, and when you listen to these kind of harmonium legends like Panditji, you then realize that there is so much hard work and there is so much sadhana involved in this, isn't it? It's so amazing. And in fact, if you notice, when he was playing the jhala, even in that jhala, he was doing laikari. He was playing with the rhythm, playing with the tabla player, literally toying with the tal, even at that fast pace. It is just so amazing. And at the same time, keeping the control on the keys with his fingers, you know, that is truly, truly legendary stuff. So after the scintillating performance in Rag Yaman, we now listen to an afternoon melody, Rag Vrindavani Sarang, in which Panditji will play a composition in Teen Taal. So let's listen to that, Rag Vrindavani Sarang.
Speech on. File info, 02 Rag Vrindavani Sarang, MP, selected, speech off.
Uh-huh. Wow, that was Raag Vrindavani Sarang. After having heard these two absolutely magical classical compositions from Panditji, we are now going to listen to, as I mentioned at the beginning, he's such an amazing player of light music on the harmonium, light and devotional music. He's also played several Marathi Natya Sangeet on the harmonium that we can hear on YouTube. But this one is a very, very popular abhang by Sant Namdev Maharaj, popularized by Pandit Bhimsen Joshi ji, whom Borkar Guruji accompanied several times. And this is the abhang, Tirtha Vitthala, Kshetra Vitthala. So let's listen to this.
Speech on. File in 03 Tirtha Vitthala Kshetra Vitthala. Select / speech off.
Popular Abhang Tirtha. And see, if you listen to the way he plays, right, the song on the harmonium, you know, the subtleties, like, I mean, just to give you an example, like, so each and every letter of the line is clearly shown on the harmonium when he plays, right? So that is the key to playing light music, because light music songs have so many words, and it is, as we call, a shabda pradhan gayaki sugam sangeet, right? So it's very important that when you are playing songs on instruments, you have to first of all know the song. And sometimes what happens is people think that, oh, every stanza is the same tune, so I'll, you know, just play just as I played the previous stanza. But that's not how it works, because every stanza has different words. So even if the stanzas have the same tune, they have to represent the words in that stanza. So the way the words are, that's the way the song has to come out on the instrument. And that is something that we get to learn from Panditji. And as I said, especially on an instrument like harmonium, which already has its inherent limitations. So the next one is, as I've always mentioned in all these sessions, is my favorite part of the program, which is the interview of the artist. It's in Marathi though, but I'm sure that all of you can definitely gather the gist of the interview, people who don't follow Marathi. And of course, I will talk about what he mentioned in the interview briefly after the interview is done. So here we go. Interview with Panditji.
Speech on. File 04 interview. MP. Select. Speech on.
Guru Lavale. विष्णुपंत वस्त असतील किंवा मधुकर पेडणेकर आणि त्याच्यानंतर छोटा गंधर्व, हो, काय मिळालं ह्या सगळ्यांकडनं?
पहिले वस्त गुरु चालत आले हो, देवीची कृपा आमच्या नवदुर्गेची. गुरु असे आम्ही दुपारी खेळत होतो, माझ्या वयाची मुलं, 4-5 मुलं, आणि खेळता खेळता दुपारचे 2:30 वाजले होते. ते वस्त एकदम आले आणि ओरडले, काय रे म्हणाले मूर्खानं, तुम्हाला काय कळतंय काय? हा आम्ही झोपलोय तिथे असं तसं आहे आणि तुम्ही बड करताय, चला म्हणाल गप्प बसा. बर, हे ऐकल्यावर माझे ते सवंगडी ते त्याने पोबारा केला. मी एकटाच राहिलो, मला अशी शीड आली होती. खरं म्हणजे वय लहान होतं, 12 वर्षाचं वय होतं त्यावेळी, पण असा मनातून चिडलो होतं आणि त्यांच्याकडे बघत होतो. म्हटलं काय माणूस आहे हा, तर तेच राहील. मध्ये 4-6 सेकंड गेले आणि ते म्हणाले, काय रे म्हणाले, पेटी शिकायची का तुला? पेटी शिकायची? असं गुस्सातच म्हटलं, हो शिकायची.
एवढ्या सगळ्या मुलांच्या त्यांनी हा प्रश्न फक्त तुम्हाला विचारला?
हो, कारण ती मुलं राहिली नाही, ती गुल. त्याच्यामुळे
काहीतरी दैवी योगा होता तुम्ही तिकडे थांबण्यामध्ये.
योगच योगच. आणि मग पुढच्या आठवड्यात आमचा दौरा गेला नागपूरला, मग तिथं सुरुवात केली. पेटी त्यांचीच, माझ्याकडे पेटी नव्हती, गरिबी होती. तर त्यांनीच पेटी दिली. उठ म्हणाले, 4 वाजता पहाटे उठवला मला. त्या दिवशी 5 तास पहिल्यांदा बसवलं, 5 तास म्हणाले वाजवत बस. आणि मग ते झाल्यावर 5 तासांनी आले, पुन्हा 1 तासाने हे म्हणाले. असं करता करता 14 तास पहिल्या दिवशी माझी मेहनत करून घेतली. असे 6 महिने, 12-14, 12-14 तास.
म्हणजे हार्मोनियमचा पहिला स्पर्श झाला तोच मुळात 12-14 तासाच्या रियाजानी झाला. त्यामुळेच आयुष्यभर कधीही पुढे रियाज सुटला नाही.
नाही सुटला, अजूनही नाही.
पंडितजी अजूनही रियाज करू नये का? आता रियाज करावासा वाटतो? आता सगळे राग तुमच्या बोटांवर बसलेले आहेत. भारतीय अभिजात शास्त्रीय संगीतातला असा कुणीही दिग्गज नसेल की ज्याला तुम्ही साथ दिली नसेल.
जरी असलं तर काय आहे, आपण जे मिळवलेले आहे ते टिकवण्यासाठी म्हणून हे करावं लागतं. मिळवणं सोपं असतं, टिकवणं कठीण असतं.
वा,
तसं त्याच्यासाठी. आणि मग त्याच्यात एक काय असतं, एक लगन दोघांची, नाहीतर मग चैनच पडत नाही. तळमळ होते, अरे रे आज हात लावला नाही, हार्मोनियमला हात लावला नाही, तळमळ असतो.
तुम्ही ज्या काळात पेटी वादनाला सुरुवात केली त्या काळामध्ये पेटी वादनाला फारशी प्रतिष्ठा नव्हती, किंबहुना साथीच्या कलावंतालाच प्रतिष्ठा नव्हती. अशा काळामध्ये आपल्या बरोबर इतरांच्या कोणाचं पेटी वादन आपण ऐकलं आणि त्याचा काही आपल्यावर प्रभाव पडला का?
प्रभाव मग अशी मी सांगितल्याप्रमाणे ते जनार्दन बोरकर म्हणून कीर्तनाला साथ करायचे, त्यांची बसण्याची स्टाईल वगैरे. आता जो नखरा त्यांच्या बसणार अभिनय म्हणतो, जो अभिनय माझ्याकडे नाही आहे तर तो त्यांच्याकडे होता, देखणे होते. आणि ते मला भावलं एक. आणि त्यावेळी नाव ऐकून होतो गोविंदराव टेंबे नावाचे कोणतरी महाराष्ट्रात आहेत आणि एक नंबरचे हार्मोनियम वादक आहेत, तर त्यांचं नाव ऐकलं होतं. पण मला ही ओढ लागली नवदुर्गेच्या देवळात आणि तिनं सगळं हे करून घेतले, अजूनही माझी श्रद्धा आहे.
त्या नवदुर्गेनं तुम्हाला एक प्रकारे आशीर्वाद दिला आणि तुम्ही मग पंडित भीमसेन जोशी असे असेल, जितेंद्र अभिषेकी, किशोरी आमोणकर या सगळ्यांना साथ केली. या प्रत्येक गायकाचा बाज वेगळा, घराणं वेगळं, सादरीकरणाची शैली वेगवेगळी, त्यांची तबियत वेगळी, हे सगळं असताना त्यांच्या बरोबर साथ करताना तुमच्या वादनामध्ये काही फरक करावा लागला तुम्हाला?
आता फरक करावा लागतो, प्रत्येकाची स्टाईल वेगळी असते. भीमसेनजींची स्टाईल किराणा गायकी, परत त्यांचे स्वतःचं काही त्याच्यामध्ये मिश्रण, खूप घराण्याचं एकत्रीकरण केलं होतं भीमसेनजींनी, तर त्यांच्या अंगाने जावं लागायचं. आता मल्लिकार्जुन मनसुरांच्या बरोबर त्यांच्या अंगाने जावं लागायचं, त्यांची वेगळी पद्धत होती. आता छोटा गंधर्व गायची त्यांच्याप्रमाणे असं वाटलं पाहिजे साथ संगत करताना. तिथे आपली काही नको आहे, आपली विद्वत्ता किंवा आपली काय दाखवायची जरूर नाहीये. तिथे पाणी तेरा रंग कैसा जिसमे मिला वैसा, असं पाहिजे की लोकांना वाटलं अरे काय हो गाणंच आहे हो, असं वाटलं पाहिजे. असे मला साथीदार ऐकायला मिळाले. केशवराव कांबळे ऑर्गन वादक होते, त्यांची संगत मी ऐकली आणि असं वाटलं अरे काय म्हटले, गातायत का वाचतय, काय चाललंय का, इतकं एक रूप. आणि ते आदर्श मला मिळाल्यामुळे मी काहीतरी करू शकलो, घडलो.
तुमच्या पिढीने प्रचंड मोठा संगीत रंगभूमीचा एक सुवर्ण काळ पाहिला.
हो,
त्याच्यामध्ये छोटा गंधर्व, प्रसाद सावकार, राम मराठे, त्याच्या आधीच्या काळामध्ये जर आपण पाहिलं तर अगदी बालगंधर्वांपासून ते केशवराव भोसले, दीनानाथ मंगेशकर, प्रचंड मोठी माणसं. पूर्वीच्या काळामध्ये देखील आपल्याकडे पंडित जितेंद्र अभिषेकी असे अनेक दिग्गज संगीतकार होऊन गेले की ज्यांनी मराठी नाट्य संगीताची पालखी प्रचंड मोठ्या ताकदीनं पुढे नेली. परंतु आज हे मराठी संगीत नाटक आम्हाला कुठे दिसत नाही. म्हणजे राहुल देशपांडे सुद्धा गायला बसतात तेव्हा त्यांना फरमाईश होते ती नाट्यपदांची. शौनक जेव्हा गायला बसतात तेव्हा फरमाईश होते ती नाट्यपदांची. परंतु ती नाट्यपद ज्या नाटकात आहेत ते संगीत नाटक मात्र आज आम्हाला कुठे दिसत नाही, त्याला प्रेक्षक नाही.
बरोबर,
कधी ऊर्जितावस्था येईल ही अवस्था, याचं कारण काय?
कारण एकच झालं, एक तर त्या काळी करमणूक नव्हती. आता बघा, बालगंधर्व ज्या काळात होते त्या काळात ना सिनेमा होता, टेलिव्हिजन तर नव्हतंच, फक्त ग्रामोफोन तबकडी, ग्रामोफोनची रेकॉर्ड 70
चावीनं फिरवायची, चावीनं
फिरवायचा
ग्रामोफोन आजोबांकडे होती.
हा, ते करमणुकीचं साधन. तो ग्रामोफोन सुद्धा सावकार किंवा असे मोठमोठे लोकांच्या घरी असायचा, सर्वसाधारण लोकांना ऐपत नव्हती घ्यायची. त्यामुळं करमणूक म्हणजे काय तर कीर्तन, भजन आणि आपलं हे नाटक.
नाटक
नाटक सुद्धा परवडणारं नव्हतं त्यावेळेला. पहिलं तिकीट 5 रुपये असायचं, 5 रुपये म्हणजे झाले काय त्यावेळी. आणि सोनं म्हणे 15 रुपये तोळा त्यावेळी. आता 15 रुपये तोळा सोनं तर 5 रुपये तिकीट पहिलं ते परवडणारं नाही. मग शेवटी पीठ म्हणून असायचं, खुर्च्या मध्ये पीठ आणि ओटा असं काय 3 प्रकार. शेवट तिकीट 10 का 6 आणे मी पाहिलेलं 1947 साली. तर 6 आणे तिकीट काढून लोक आपले बसायचे आणि तिथपर्यंत लोकांना ऐकू जायचं. स्पीकर नव्हते, काही नाही, लाऊडस्पीकर नव्हते, माईक नव्हते. नानासाहेब फाटक, छोटा गंधर्व, हिराबाई, हिराबाईंचं गाणं सुद्धा फार तिथपर्यंत शेवटपर्यंत ऐकू जायचं. कारण सगळी शांतता असायची, झालं लोक तल्लीनतेने ऐकायचे. कारण करमणूकच दुसरी नाही. ही करमणूक एकदा ऐकली की 15
प्राणांच्या सर्व शक्ती कर्णांच्या ठाई एकवटून श्रोते ऐकतायत अशी परिस्थिती होती.
हो हो, आज ते नाही झालंय. आज काय झालंय, सगळे मिळाले आपल्याला, सिनेमा आला, सिनेमा नंतर मग
टेलिव्हिजन आलं,
टेलिव्हिजन आलं,
इंटरनेट आलं, मोबाईल वरची एंटरटेनमेंट आली,
सगळं आता घरात बसल्या बसल्या उठायचीच नाही हो, कोण जाणार तर बुकिंग करा मध्ये जा लाईन लावा हे करा जरूर नाही बसल्या, त्याच्यामुळे हे नाटकाचं वगैरे हे कमी झालं असं मला वाटतं. बरं नाटकात गेल्यावर गाणं कळतं असे सगळेच लोक नसतात, ज्यांना सिनसिनेरी आवडते, ज्यांना वेगवेगळे काय चमत्कृती आवडते, ट्रिक्सिन आवडतात, सिनेमात दिसतात, नाटकात तशी दिसत नाही.
झी 24 तास रहा एक पाऊल पुढे.
That was interesting. Yeah, that was just last conclusion to the interview. Yeah, I didn't realize that I had to cut that. Sorry about that. But anyway, yeah, so such interesting points he said. So basically he was mentioning as to how he started playing the harmonium. So his first teacher, he yelled at all those boys playing outside in the afternoon. Everybody else ran except him, and what should the person ask? Hey, will you come and play harmonium? So it was just such an amazing coincidence. It was like, as he said, daiva yoga, you know, it was totally God's plan that he had to be there alone, and the person Pandit Vishnu Pantavasta had to ask him, will you play the harmonium? And then of course he mentioned about how he began playing the harmonium and how he practiced right from the beginning for 12 to 14 hours a day. And till date, he would practice. And then, of course, he mentioned as to how differently he has to accompany different artists based on their style of singing. And he said something very interesting as to while accompanying, you don't have to show your ability. You have to adjust to what the artist sings and you have to try to play according to his style of singing. That's such an amazing thing that we got to learn and we got to hear from Panditji. And then finally, he said as to why people going to the theaters or going to auditoriums to listen to music, the number has reduced simply because the entertainment is at their fingertips now. Sitting at home, entertainment is available through various platforms. So that's the reason why he said that live performances have lesser audience. Having said that, you know, they say that it's a cycle, and I'm pretty sure, I have no doubt that golden age is again going to come. So such a, you know, such an amazing interview, and you know, you can actually make out from the way he talks that such an epitome of humility, right? So you know, just such an amazing artist, and you know, we are so blessed that we are living in this era when Panditji also was with us. The next one is again a very, very popular bhajan. Payo ji maine Ram Ratan Dhan Payo. So let's listen to that on the harmonium.
Speech on 505 Payo ji main. Select / speech off.
Uh-huh. वाह, दैट वाज पायोजी मैने, द वेरी पॉपुलर मीरा भजन. टू कंक्लूड आवर टुडेज सेशन, पंडित जी विल बी प्लेइंग फॉर अस ए कॉम्पोजिशन इन राग भैरवी. A very melodious and a very a composition full of intricacies, subtleties that we will listen to now in Teen Taal. So Raag Mishra Bhairavi.
Speech on 506 Raag Bhairavi MP select / speech off.
Ah. So amazing. Let's all bow down to this legendary harmonium player, Pandit Tulsidas Bolkarji. And let's pray to the Lord Almighty that may his legacy be preserved by several of his very renowned students. May they in turn inspire many other students to take up harmonium playing and take it up in the true sense, and take it up like a sadhana and not just casual playing, right? So with that, we conclude our session for today. Thank you so much for all those who are able to attend this session. And I must tell you that, you know, it is always such an amazing feeling to be able to present all these sessions to all of you. So let's all pray to the Lord Almighty that he gives us the strength and the right direction for all of us to progress in our musical journey. So thank you so much, and the next session, which will be the last session for 2021, session 16, will be held on Sunday, December 12th, second Sunday, December 12th, same time from 5:30 p.m. Eastern time. Till then, stay safe and happy Thanksgiving. And I think Seshadriji had asked me that I should not conclude the session because he wanted to say something. So over to you, Seshadriji, and namaskar.
Thank you, sir. And like you said, magical fingers, magical session. Thank you so much. So just wanted to remind everybody that the upcoming Baade No Bahar Ghazal concert is on December the 4th in New Jersey. This is Manoj sir's annual tribute to the legend Mehdi Hasan Saab. And if you have not bought your tickets yet, urge you to quickly do so. This is the 10th year in succession that sir will be regaling us, enthralling us with ghazals from the maestro. So I'm sure this one is really going to be a memorable one. So please support us and do share this information with music lovers everywhere, amongst your friends, amongst your family. Thank you so much. So with that, sir, with your permission, we will conclude today's session.
Sure.
Thank you. Have a good evening.
Thank you so much, everyone. Namaskar.
Thank you. Namaskar.